2006, which I think is the first installment in this franchise. They may have had games prior to that, but if they did, they were under a different name, but honestly, I'm not too sure. Anyway, like I said, we're going to be playing a little bit of baseball. Going to do an easy, relaxed playthrough. Going to keep it realistic, but not get too crazy with it. Now, really quickly, I don't know whether anyone watching knows a lot about baseball. Major League Isn't quite as loud or noisy as the Xbox controller, so we'll kind of see how this goes. Alright, so let's adjust the roster for the regular season. We have our six pitchers here. We want to send down last year, so I want to keep him out of the closures role for right now. As for the lineups, we have Nimmo in center field. McNeil is at third. Cano's at second. Alonso's at first. So we'll make sure that stays the same. Davis is in left, and Conforto's in right. Then we have Ramos and Rosario at the bottom. As for DH, we have Dom Smith versus right-handers. And let's see. We'll put in Cespedes against lefties. And I'm not going to worry too much again in this playthrough about the order. Just stick with it. But yeah, I think that does it. So let's get into the regular season. So I do plan to simulate as we have our first injury of the year. Brandon Nimmo will be out 1 to 2 weeks. So 10-day DL. Cespedes, but we'll put Marisnik in there as Cespedes is the DH. So let's keep going. Alright, Nimmo is back. We'll send Parker back down and we'll readjust. on my own. So that would definitely be something I'm interested in doing. So we might do that moving forward. We can do any team. It doesn't have to be the Mets because they're my favorite. We can do any team, any kind of playthrough. I know a lot of channels on YouTube that cover this game do get pretty creative with different playthroughs or simulations, so we can do some of that. But for the draft, we do have a few blue chip prospects to choose from, as we are the 19th team to pick. So I'm thinking either this guy Heron or Maraville, but I'm thinking Heron's the better player from his attributes. So round two, I don't think there's any more blue chips, so we'll go off of potential, and I'll look for blue chips, and then I'll move to 80 potential, and green accuracy, and then yellow, and then if there's no one left, or no one left that I like, I'll move down to 75, and do the same thing from there. It's kind of just starting at the top and going through them and slowly going further down, obviously. And if we still get picks, I start moving up back up to 80 and going through the red, in which I'm really just taking a few shots in the dark. But let's see who's available. I definitely don't like the looks of his hitting stats. We have another closer, a starter who doesn't look too bad. His home runs and control are a little low. I might take this guy, Harris. All around pretty good. There's a couple of relievers here that are also looking good, but he's someone else as well. I might take him. He's only 18 years old, so let's do that. There tend to be a lot more pitchers than hitters available in the draft that are worth taking, so if we can get a good hitter, I'd rather try for that. Let's see. I actually like Barker there. I think it's between Barker and Henry Ramirez, but I think I'm gonna go with Barker because he's younger. So we'll see if Ramirez is still available, and he is, so we'll take him, and then we'll head into the 75 overall potentials. He's got really good contact, so he's going to be a good average hitter, or he should be. His fielding is not that great, and playing in the National League, that could be an issue. So let's see if there's anyone else, and I do want to, again, try to not take too many pitchers if I don't have to. So we'll probably go with Roark there. Round number 5. first pick could have been a little bit better, but it's still an A potential, so I like that. He is already a 72, which is really good. Montanez, he needs a little bit of time to develop, but he could be a solid hitter, if not a bench bat. Looks like we got a really good reliever in Barker. And Ramirez looks pretty good too, but again, needs to develop a bit. So Roark, we're not going to sign. Sneeze there. We're on a bit of a losing streak here, so that's not too good. never know. All right, let's see if we had anyone. So Jacob DeGrom and Noah Syndergaard made the All-Star team, and I think that's a big reason why we are doing so well, because they're both pitching pretty well. Nobody in the bullpen made it. We got Ramos, having a really good season, made the All-Star team at catcher. And that's it. We got three guys. And right now, we are in first place. Doing really well, actually. We are ranked 5th overall in the sport for best team. And, not a big speed team. Really bad on defense, but really solid nonetheless. And we are 9.5 games ahead of the Braves. That's a really nice cushion. Although, it'll look nicer once we get to the end of August, as they can definitely still come back. And we are 24 games over 500, which is really good. So, with that being said, we are going to wrap this video up. Wasn't really sure what exactly to do for this, so I figured we'd just do a simple playthrough. And I think I'll do a second video to finish the season out.